amazing. Yeah? I'm blown away by this.
This is the place where Ever Given was anchored after it was
refloated.
And right around that bend
was where she went aground.
What's up guys, welcome back to another beautiful day at sea. We are currently in the Mediterranean Sea after departure from Port Tangimed in the last video.
Here we are.
And tonight, we are going to transit the Suez Canal and I'll take you along with me, the very famous Suez Canal where the Ever Given incident happened. So before proceeding to the Suez Canal, we have a series of checklists made by the chief officer for the junior officers and the deck ratings and also the engineers, and we have to comply with and complete it before proceeding. So guys, today we'll be preparing the gangway, the Suez Canal projector lights, then the monorail, etc, etc. I'll show you that when I go on deck. Also, we have a steering plan made by the chief officer in which the ABs will rotate every 30 minutes, the helmsman, because it gets really tiring and we need concentration and attention at all times, so no mistakes. Most important thing before the transit, we prepare our refreshments, the cookies and the coffee and the sky flakes, not to forget the tea. And yeah, that's very important because the transit is for 12, 13, 14 hours and you need all of that during the transit.
Both anchors are unlatched.
Both anchors are unlatched. Thank you, Marvin. So like I was telling you guys, we are doing the pre-arrival preparations. So for the pre-arrival preparation, this was the Suez Canal projector lights which we have connected, and sometimes when we transit and there is low lighting, so we can use this for navigation. And also we have set up the anchor, and you can see the anchor wash connected, hose connected. So we are going to come here tonight and do the anchoring before proceeding forward in the morning. Also the monorail, it is unlashed to pick up the service boat, which I'll show you tomorrow morning. So it is 1800 in the evening and now I will take over from the chief officer, do my 6 on 6 off. During the Suez Canal transit, we junior officers go 6 on 6 off before the entrance of Suez Canal and after the exit. So it's going to be a long night and I will prepare the bridge with all the checklists, do the reporting as required, lot of reportings here, and then proceed for anchor. So that's where we are currently, and that's the entrance of the Suez Canal. So still some time to go. We have a beautiful Tripoli, our sister ship Marcel Maersk, coming out of Suez Canal, and now it's our turn, and a beautiful sunset. So we are back in business and I'm going to go forward for the anchorage now, and then we will slowly pick it up in the morning and proceed to my favorite place, the place where my channel actually picked up, the Suez Canal. So Rahul, are you ready?
I'm ready to
Ready to drop anchor?
Drop anchor.
Let's go.
I'm ready to rumble.
Well, that'll be the port anchor. Just making it ready now. And switching on some more lights. So guys, we have engaged the winch now, as you can see. Put the pin here. Yeah, that's how anchor is made ready. We engage it, anchor bar is up. There is our control station. That's the station. And I know it's a bit dark, but I have this flashlight, so it'll serve the purpose. Rahul right now is testing if everything is okay. He will be at the control. I will have a look at what's happening.
Now we are back for mode.
Okay, Rahul.
It means the anchor, we use it.
Is engaged. Copy, Captain. We'll start lowering the port anchor now.
Yeah, okay. Thank you.
So guys, we have done our anchoring and Rahul is just disengaging now. And we have around 5 shackles on deck. So it is 2200 and I'm back inside. I'll go for my remaining watch, anchor watch, and tomorrow morning 6 o'clock we see you on the Suez Canal entrance, at Suez Canal entrance, not on. Yeah, by the way, yeah, it feels good to be back in the Suez. So this is how the bridge is looking right now. All the lights on, the red lights on the bridge. So we will wait here now at Anchorage for the next 2-3 hours depending on our convoy number, which we have to give a watch on the relevant channel. Then the captain will be called and we'll heave up the anchor. So maybe another 2-3 hours, so captain will have a long night and we too. It's 5:55 a.m. in the morning and we are back in Suez Canal. As you can see behind me, this particular canal is close to me because it's because of this canal that my YouTube channel exploded. And if you haven't seen the previous video, you can watch it. It was a beautiful transit we had with Captain Marcin on Emma Merce. And today we're gonna have another transit. I am a bit tired because of the 6-on-6-off, but that's how life is. We've got the bridge coming up soon, made by Japan, the Mubarak Peace Bridge, and yeah, it's becoming sunny now, becoming clear, so at least the time lapse will be better. What a beautiful view this is! Incredible! Stretching all the way from the port side to the starboard side to the city. We've got a breakfast with the view of the canal. Beautiful transit. Also, we are keeping an eye on the weather at all times. We have a weather forecast which I'll show you. And if there's bank effect, suppose the vessel starts moving to starboard, then since you know we have two engines, so we stop the starboard engine and we give speed to the port side engine. So that's the advantage of having two engines. Welcome to Egypt, and there's a famous monument over here with the construction workers with the helm, constructed back in 1856. So guys, it's our decadent Natalie's first time here in Suez. I know the sun is too harsh, but that's how Egypt is, right?
Yeah.
So how was your experience first time?
It's absolutely amazing. Yeah? I'm blown away by this.
What's the part which is, you know, which is like the first time you've seen for like in a while, like the contrast which you were talking about?
Yeah, it's just so different from like Denmark and Europe. Now we've been to all these ports in Europe. It's
correct.
It's something completely else.
Correct.
And when you look at the Suez Canal, like, yeah, part of it is completely green and the other one's just desert.
That's the green part and that's the desert.
And you've got this mighty ship with us with the blue waters and the blue funnel. And Natalie, I think this is once in a lifetime experience, yeah?
It is.
Yeah, really. All right, Natalie, let's go and maneuver our ship, yeah? So the contrast between the
port side, the desert side, and the starboard side, the green side, is because the Nile River is running over there and therefore they get fresh water.
And on that side now, what they've done is they're digging underwater canals. So they're building a city over there. And I think over the next few years, when we come back here, we'll see a much more greener side. This is the place where Emma Gibbon was anchored after it was
refloated. Right here in the Great Bitter Lakes. You can see many, many, many ships at anchor, both the sides.
And we've been here before with Emma. And right around that bend
was where she went aground.
So perhaps when we come northbound next time, I'll show you the exact location of it. So finally, after 6 hours, it's time to have my lunch. And then I'll go on deck and show you the mooring boats and the tugs which are escorting us, yes. So guys, I just had my lunch and this is going to be a good walk around the ship, but I wanted to show you a few things before I end this video. So hence, let's go.
This is the Swiss Canal boat which we picked up
last night, and these are the dredging operations going on. So Ever Given was also refloated because of these dredgers and many other things. So basically this boat carries the Swiss Canal inspector, the electricians, etc., etc. If there's an emergency, if we need them. So they are with us on board in the Swiss room. Especially after the Ever Given incident, the canal authorities, the port authorities, the pilots, the inspectors, everybody are paying a lot of attention towards the safety and the speed part of the vessel. And today we didn't cross 10 knots. We were just doing 8 to 9 knots maximum. And we had a tug escorting us throughout the journey, which I will show you. I would say the Ever Given incident was a big lesson for all. And I hope this thing never happens ever again. The dredger operations, everything, as you see, are going on continuously. So, so far, so good. Have a look at these two tugs.
Number one and number two.
They have been escorting us since the beginning of the canal, and they will be with us throughout the entire journey, another 2-3 hours. So that is what I was telling you, much more attention being paid to the emergency contingency plans, you know. Another 30 nautical miles to go and we'll be out of the canal, and I think I should go now and sleep because I've been out on deck making this video for the past 2 hours. So do hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, share the video, and I hope you like the video. And yeah, I need to catch a breath.
That's Swiss Canal right from the bow section.
Yeah, see you later guys.